I assume Disney's smart when they made their decision. I don't know what metrics they used, but I think metrics alone can lead us down a bad direction with influencers. And it's the same on the other side. Like we know many people who would be considered to be influencers, and they've worked with brands and it's been the wrong brand. And they just wanted to earn money doing it, which is their right. But they made these relationships with brands that weren't good for them and ended up kind of selling out a little bit and weakening their platform. So I just think it's a complicated relationship between brand and influencer. And it takes a lot more than metrics. It takes a hard discussion about, these are our brand values. We're not going to tolerate, you know, anti-Semitic comments. We're not going to tolerate. And maybe it needs to be as spelled out as something like that, which maybe isn't something they had to worry about when you're working with a newspaper or a television station, because those media outlets already had those rules in place. And a one-person influencer might not have those rules in place. They might not have those, you know, kind of boundaries around what they're comfortable doing and not doing already in place.